After the Wright brothers successfully invent the airplane, they began to look for customers to sell their airplane to, and one of the obvious customers was the military. By 1908, the U.S. Army was interested in the Wright brothers' airplane and put out an advertisement for bids, but of course there were a number of performance specifications. It had to meet a minimum speed of 40 miles an hour, be able to operate in commonplace terrain, and be relatively simple to operate so pilots could be trained in a short period of time. The specifications also called for the airplane to be easily disassembled and to be transported by wagon so it could be taken wherever the airplane needed to operate. In 1908, the Wright brothers had to perform a series of flight trials to demonstrate that their airplane could achieve these specifications. During that flight, there was a malfunction with the airplane. One of the propellers split and caused the airplane to crash. Orville's passenger, the Army observer, Thomas Selfridge, died later that evening of his injuries, the first fatality in a powered airplane. The Wright brothers came back in 1909 with a new airplane and completed those performance trials and met all the requirements the Army needed. The Army purchased the airplane for $30,000, which was an extraordinary sum in the day, and making it the world's first military airplane. The 1909 Wright military flyer was given to the Smithsonian in 1911. It still retains its original fabric from that time period, and it's the most original of the three Wright brothers airplanes in the museum's collection.